formula for point school corn is a little bit different than the way you learned it last year. This year, it is y equals, so it starts out the same way as slope-intercept form. M, which is what? That's your slope. Times, now you're going to put parentheses, x minus x1, right? So which one of those two is your changing number? The x or the x1? X1. This is where you're going to plug in your number. Plus y1. Okay? You are going to ignore this right here. We're not going to do that. We're not going to distribute. And we're going to leave it just like that. Okay? So, if you remember, yesterday we sometimes labeled our points x1, y1, x2, y2, right? Okay, so I'm going to label this x1, y1 because that's going to tell me where I put that in. My slope, what letter stands for my slope? Is my m. So I'm going y equals, what's my m?
2.
2 times, now I'm going x minus, what is my x1?
4.
Plus, what is my y1?
1.
1. Boom, done. That's it. Okay, so, helping me set up number 2 is going to be Radisha. So I'm going y equals 1 half, and then in parentheses, x minus 2 plus 4, beautiful. So far, so good? All right. So, setting up number 3, Sam. Ooh, careful, x minus what? Yeah, there you go, because it's going to be x minus negative 6. So that turns into plus 6. And then plus 0. Do I have to write plus 0?
No.
No, I can just leave it just like that. Okay? So Jeff, you're setting up 4? Which turns into a plus 8, because minus a negative 8 is going to be a plus 8. And then at the end? Yep, so, yeah, so we're going to just write it as minus 1. If you wrote it as plus negative 1, probably not going to mark that wrong. Okay, but we try to not have two signs next to each other. Okay, number 5, Brody.
Y equals negative 1. Parentheses x plus 4.
Ooh, careful. X.
Minus
4. There you go.
Minus 3.
Good. Minus 3. This inside the parentheses is opposite, outside the parentheses is the same, because if you remember, it's that y equals m, because it's x minus x1, because we're subtracting there, but then we're adding our y1 at the end. Okay? So, Marshall, Yeah, I'm just going to end my parenthesis there because I don't have to write plus 0 or minus 0. And I'm not going to mark it wrong if you do write minus 0. Then what? Plus negative 9 or just minus 9, yep. Okay. I want to take a peek. I want you to take a peek at number 5 quick. Okay? Anybody know how else they might write this a little bit? This might look like y equals, they might just put a negative sign right there. Because remember that stands for a negative 1, it's that imaginary negative 1. Okay? Not so bad, right? Alright, so now if I have 2 points, what piece of information am I missing? I'm missing the slope. But do I know how to find the slope with 2 points? I do. What's my formula? Oh, but with how, you're right. It's rise over on the graph. Y2 minus Y1. X2 minus X1. And once I have my slope, then I can put it in 2-point slope form, which still doesn't change. Christian, how do I find the slope in number 7?
Negative 1 minus
2. Okay. Y2 minus Y1. Which was labeled as Y1. Okay. Over 1 plus 3. Good. So on top I have formula. Because now I have my slope, right? I've got M. So I need M and I need 1 point. Which point should I use? Yeah, we're going to use the first point and my slope to write out my point slope form. So written in point slope form, this guy's going to look like what?
Y equals negative 2 parentheses x plus 3, so it's all plus 7.
Plus 7, very good. Alright. Chuck, help me find slope in number 8. Careful, what's got to go on top? They have to go to my y. So that turns into a plus over ooh, careful. Negative 6 minus 3. So on top I've got three. On the bottom I've got negative 9. Did we do that right? I've got a couple people giving me a dirty look.
I just did it with
you did it with negative 4 plus 7, but you got the same answer, right? Okay, so that's okay to do as long as if you start with this point, you've got to start with this point on the bottom. Okay? So this turns into a who? Positive 1/3. Okay, so remind ourselves, we're going slope at our first point, and minus 7. There you go. Okay, so it's opposite inside your parentheses. It's the same outside your parentheses. All right. Lacey, help me find slope of 9. Yeah, so minus negative 1 turns into a plus 1. 4 minus 2, so on top we have over 2. Good. Can I reduce that? Nope. So we leave it. And Lauren, you're putting this in point slope for me? There you go, minus 2. Minus 1, very good. Alright, find and slope in number 10, Talon. Plus 3, there you go. So on top we've got
15
over, which is good. Coin slope form, Ted. X plus who? Oh, careful. X goes with X. There you go. 3. Ooh, minus 8. There you go. Alright, slope at 11, Connor.
Negative 1 plus 3, negative 4 plus 6.
So on top I've got
2
over
2,
which is
1.
So point slope 4, margin. Christian, open your eyes.
Y equals 1.
Good. Do I need this one right here? No. So sometimes you'll see it without that one line right there. If you write that one, not a big deal. Okay? It's still correct if you write that one. I just want you to know that sometimes you'll see it without the one. Does that make sense? Okay? Tyler, find the slope in 12. Good, so on top I have over, which gives me negative 1 half, yep. So point slope form, Timothy. Okay, not so bad, right? Pretty self-explanatory as long as you've got